It's Facebook earnings call disasters world, and we're just here living in it. This is your morning jolt, and all eyes on Facebook as its stock absolutely gets destroyed following its horrible second quarter earnings call. And I think what ultimately serves up at least three lessons for investors off of what happened to Facebook. First up, when a business is valued amazingly for amazing things as Facebook has been, and the growth rates are slowing, chances are there could be a quarterly letdown, and the stock can react very harshly. Memo to the bulls: bad things do happen to good companies. Next up, second lesson for them: don't be blinded by the bull case. Realize that there's always a bear case to every company. So if you went into Facebook thinking everything is absolutely amazing, you are ultimately hit with a sense of reality off of that. Growth rates are slowing, they're investing more to protect their business. Wake up call. And then lastly, respect the wild card that is management. Sometimes management hops on these earnings calls and they use an environment that's happening in the broader stock market to reset expectations. You never know how management is going to use the broader market to advance their agenda or ultimately reset Wall Street expectations. So a big wake-up call to Facebook and all its bullish investors all over the world. There we go. Around Wall Street, speaking of bullish investors, RBC Capital Markets analyst, a veteran tech analyst, Mark Mahaney, out with an interesting note. He's got six reasons why you need to stay bullish for Facebook, because there's always, you have to think about the other side of the coin too as well on days like this. He has set the day. He says valuation still remains very attractive, about 17 times forward earnings, yada, yada, yada. And at the end of the day, Facebook's growth rates are slowing. That's the only thing that market cares about right now. Around Wall Street, we got a lot of stuff popping. We got Amazon earnings after the close. That's obviously going to be a big focus off of the Facebook results, but also Netflix too last week. They also disappointed, the stock got hammered. So it will be interesting to see how the market embraces Amazon, or if it even does. Boeing CEO tells me that he's very bullish on Trump's Space Force. That's kind of cool. UPS CFO, he told me he sounded a little more cautious on international. I don't know if he realized what he said, but overall, UPS is doing okay, all things considered. PayPal CEO, he talked to COO. Bill already talked to our Annie Gauss after earnings on Wednesday evening. Bullish on M&A. Overall strong quarter for Action Alerts plus holding PayPal. Market is viewing it a little skeptically, but a good quarter for them. And our Catherine Ross is talking to Tenable CEO on their IPO. She'll be at the NASDAQ doing her thing. That'll be a cool one to watch as well. And before you go, Under Armour. The stock is popping about 7% pre-market. The company remains in transition. They announced a new $80 million restructuring plan. I'm talking with the team later on today for a little bit. Overall, companies in transition, they're still seeing the effects of the shift to online shopping. Little concerned about Under Armour, but all in all, maybe not as bad as Wall Street feared. Be sure to sign up for the Morning Jolt newsletter down below and hang in there. It's going to be a crazy day.